Today, I will show you how to create this cool minimalist geometric logo design in Illustrator, as well as have answers to my most recent Q&A at the very end. Welcome back to Satori Graphics. Today's video is a minimalist geometric logo design Illustrator tutorial, but you can use these exact skills to design any kind of minimalist geometric logo design that you could incorporate your own style and ideas for. Follow along and try this one out for yourself. And at the very end, you will have my Q&A answers. So thanks a lot to all of my subscribers who posted their questions. To make our minimalistic geometric logo design, we will need to make a triangle. Set your color panel to a stroke, and then take your polygon tool and double click on the artboard. This window will appear, so type in three sides and the pixel dimensions don't really matter at the moment. I'm going to resize mine a bit here, changing the stroke weight and the size. Just make yours to a thickness similar to mine. Once you've done that, you need to duplicate the triangle. So hold down the Alt key on your keyboard until you see this icon appear, and then click and drag. Highlight both the triangles and align them with the Align tool, like so. If your window does not open, go up to Window and then Align. On one of your triangles, use a direct selection tool, aka the white arrow tool. Bring down the top point in this kind of way. To convert the triangle strokes to filled shapes, highlight both of them, then go up to Object, Path, Outline Stroke. Move the slanted triangle to the back, and then change its color so we do not get confused between the two shapes. We now want to align the triangles at the furthest point on the right. The left side we can do later. To cut out the triangle to make it seem like it's passing behind, take the pen tool and create a path like this, turning it into a fill. Duplicate the shape by holding down Alt, as we're going to need this later. Open your Pathfinder window and then select the new shape and the slanted triangle. We select the minus front option, which will cut out a section. Send the slanted triangle to the back of the logo design. And then rotate it 180 degrees and align it in place. Minus from the front again, and then ungroup the slanted triangle shape, deleting the section that we don't want in the middle. Send it to the back again. Our minimalist Illustrator logo design is taking shape, and there's not much more left to do actually now. With the direct selection tool, move the bottom left point along so it is behind the front triangle. making sure the left slant is aligned. We can carry on using the direct selection tool, adjust the points here as we see fit. Highlight both shapes, and with the Pathfinder window, unite them like so. Select the minimalistic logo design and add a gradient fill. You can obviously add any color you wish, but I'm going to go for a blue gradient from light to dark. There, it's one variety of our logo design, but we can do a bit more. Duplicate the logo and then change it to white. Select your first logo design, access the gradient, and then make a circle shape. Send the circle to the back, and then drag your logo over the top. We can change the gradient of the circle to a radial gradient like so. Looks pretty neat, huh? And obviously, we can change the circle to any color we wish. So, that was my minimalist, geometric logo design Illustrator tutorial. Coming up next are the answers to my Q&A. Thanks a lot to all of the subscribers that did shoot me some questions. I was going to videotape myself, but I need to get a new camera, and my phone or my webcam just don't cut it when it comes to quality. CJ Lotta asks, and sorry for pronouncing your names wrong by the way, when did you start graphic design and how long for? Also, can you do some more Photoshop tutorials? Yes, I can do some Photoshop tutorials. I have a playlist already. I haven't done many recently, but I'm gonna see to that, don't worry. When did I start designing? Well, in 2005, I started to study graphic design at the end of high school, but I didn't really know what I was doing, and it took a long time for me to formulate my path in the industry, and I've been doing it ever since. So 2005, yeah, that's about 12, 13 years now, I guess. Black Noise asks, what do you think of 99 Designs, and what is the best site for a beginner logo designer? Well, 99 Designs is like one of those competition websites, and I would suggest that they're good if you're learning to make designs for clients and you're still a student or studying, but I don't think they're that good for someone who's trying to get a career. They're really good for the client side of things because they can choose from a wide range of designs and it doesn't cost them any more money. But for a designer, you have to compete with so many people and you've got a slim chance of winning when you're up against, you know, 10, 20, 100 other designs. So there's no guarantee of money coming in. As far as websites go, you need to get on social media and you need to sell yourself as a designer. You need to have a good portfolio and then you need to sell yourself as a designer on Twitter, on Facebook, go into Facebook groups, get your own website. You need to get yourself out there. Ikatama Designs asks, what do you think about the design contests? This relates back to Black Noise's question, and like I said, for designers, it's a good way to practice your skills and refine your skills, but it's not going to get you a lot of money, and you have to compete against a lot of people for something that's not guaranteed. You ideally want to have clients where you are paid a deposit up front, normally 50%, 25% of the budget. That way, you know you have kind of something to fall back on, and you know you're not going to be working for nothing. You need to make sure your time is well spent and you're not working for free, basically, unless you're a student or something like that. Sam Fish asks, do I have a talent to start working in Illustrator? Of course you do. Everyone has the ability to work well in Illustrator. It just takes time, it takes practice. There's a saying that says it takes 10,000 hours to master anything. Now that's quite a broad statement, but it just shows you that you need to put in the time and the effort to get good at anything. A musical instrument, a sport, that all takes a lot of time. You don't see someone just pick up a basketball and then they're playing in the NBA 6 months later. You need to put in the time. George Gomez asks, are you a freelance designer? Well, I started off, I left university and I started freelancing straight from there. And I did spend time working in a design agency for a bit and then also a printing agency. And working in the printing agency was really good actually, because it showed me the printing process and how to set up a file perfectly for printing, which can be troublesome sometimes. But I work for myself and I move around the world from different to different places, just enjoying life. So I hope that answers your question. So thanks again to everyone who asked me these questions. Next time I'll try to get myself on video. Also, if you liked the tutorial, smash that like button and share this video to someone else who might like it too. Until next time, design your future today. Peace.